Hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Josh Kelly, and for those of you who don't know me, I'm a classical pianist who posts concert performance and classical listening videos. We're going to do something a little bit different with the format today. So I had a couple of people reach out to me to say it might serve the discussion better if I actually sit behind my own piano and play a few exercises from the piece that we're listening to, maybe discuss it in more detail and go into more analysis into the music instead of just discussing it. And as far as I'm concerned, getting behind a piano and doing all of this stuff is a win-win for me. So I'm going to go over to the piano and I'm going to do what I always do and cue the intro. Okay, so here we are. So we're going to listen to a recording of Schubert's second impromptu from the Opus 90 set by a pianist called Gregory Sokolov. And if I'm to be honest, he's not a pianist that I'm overly familiar with. I'm not well acquainted with his style. So I don't know whether the interpretations and the artistic direction he takes in this piece is incumbent within his own style, whether he's just doing this because he's playing Schubert and he's playing a Schubert impromptu. So I'm excited to see. This is going to be an educational experience for me as well. And I suppose we'll find the answers to that question as we go through some more of his material. So let's see what he's got for us. Okay, so one thing I noticed from the outset is that he's prepared himself to play this more classically. I mean, he's obviously curving those fingers, so he's getting more emphasis on the top, on his fingertip. I think that's causing a more percussive sound, which perhaps is an artistic decision on his part. For me, when I play this, I've played this a few times in concert, and I tend to go for a softer sort of legato, whereas he's obviously taking the decision to give it with more attack, which is an interesting decision to make. So he's got a lot of wrist movement there. He's shaking sort of from side to side. I think that's causing more weight on the triplets. Just as an example, I would sort of play like so, this sort of thing, whereas he's sort of shaking from side to side, so he's like. So it's got a lot of attack on that right hand. It's nice. It's actually causing a lot of a lilt within the playing, which I think is which suits it quite well. Yeah. So yeah, you get a lot of these things. So in Schubert's playing, you'll hear a lot of sequences. So in music, a sequence is basically where you have one bit of thematic material that either goes higher or goes lower. And you can do things with the dynamics accordingly with that. So obviously he's taking that decision to sort of come down and make it plateau, if you like, down, like cascade, should I say, down and down, which is interesting. Yeah, I do like that as an artistic decision. I really like the kind of bringing out those. He's really lilting on those, which I really like. I think that's an interesting choice. I mean, those are minims as well, so it's got that as a separate voice, which is very important. Generally within music, I was always taught that, you know, if you have a longer note value, then you're supposed to sort of make that louder so it rings for longer. So he's obviously doing that, but he's definitely putting a lot of weight on those parts, which I really think is a really cool artistic feature. Yeah. So you've got three things going on there. You've got the lower voice with these kind of slurred. It's also going around the circle of fourths this way. It's going backwards. But you've also got this inner voice, which you've got that kind of busyness going on within the phrase. But also on top of that, you've got this melody that lingers from time to time. So you've got this kind of that goes on top, which is absolutely beautiful. And obviously it's within his capabilities to bring those out, which is fantastic. Yeah, I really like that. On the score, I mean, I've got forte pianos. So, you know, as it's coming out, did we get to this bit yet? So we've got those bits there, you know, and you've got those sections, bringing out those. I think that's nice. You know, and bringing these top parts out, so you're growing through. You know, which I really, really like, yeah. He's bringing out those accents really, really well. Yeah, I like that. I like the fact that he's bringing out the... So he's got this... He's bringing out those... Which I think is nice. I think it suits it well. Yeah, it's kind of, and when it goes up the octave as well. Yeah, it's bringing out the three tiers of voicing really, really well. So I really like that. Fantastic performance. Yeah, the climax as well to those top parts. So when you're growing, you know, when you have those sort of, I think that's really beautifully played. I mean, I would do the same thing as well, but it's interesting that the phrasing is kind of taking the first part of the triplet, if you like, and using that as a segment to the previous phrase. Those parts where he'll kind of take a moment just to breathe, basically, is brilliantly executed, yeah. And it's actually a really nice study, because this isn't a particularly difficult piece technically to play, but I do think that it gives the opportunity for a student or somebody like that to practice just breathing between those chords. I mean, you've got this A flat chord, you're going to B flat 7 and then to E flat. So the fact that you can take a up at the top there, I think that's wonderfully done, yeah. More cascades there, so he's coming down on these, okay. Those parts are kind of almost kind of secondary to these kind of thump, you know, this thump in the left hand, which is coming out really well. He's got forzando on there, which is great, and you've got forzando on the next two up until this G flat chord, and he's going to come in with, well, let's take a look. Okay, so he's basically taken the decision to go slower, which is great. It gives him a chance to voice and phrase things differently. I do think that's an interesting decision to make, and he's definitely taken his time on the... You know, all of those parts there is really bringing those voices out, you know, this... And then... coming back in, but he's really taking time between the 8-bar phrases, which I think is a good artistic decision to make. Uncomfortable with that section, you know, when it goes when it kind of comes down and you get that clash between, You know, I was always kind of shy of bringing that out, but obviously he's bringing it. I've just realised how out of tune my piano is, so apologies for that. I need to get this tuned immediately. But I think that's a cool thing to bring out. Obviously, it's written for a reason, and to have that kind of dissonance between the harmonies is good. So it's going, obviously, generally speaking, as it gets higher in pitch, you're going to get louder. Not always the case, it's not always true. Obviously, every rule can be broken. In there when he's kind of taking the time to, you know, bring that growth up. I think that's really well executed. You know, I think the fact that he's growing and growing and growing again is just, it's sort of testament to the fact that, you know, higher in pitch, the louder it'll become. There is actually a mechanical reason for that as well. Obviously on piano, when you're really low down the piano, it booms more, and then when you're high up, it's very thin, so it makes sense that, you know, you will get louder on the upper registers rather than the lower ones. So type of thing. I mean, obviously, you know, it's the same melody, if you like, and it's mostly the same harmony as well. I do notice that in the left hand on this reading, I can't remember if he did it on the first one, but he's bringing out and joining up this. So you've got that as kind of a counter to the main sort of, you know, that part. I mean, most of what I'm probably going to say on this is going to be similar or have echoes of similarity, because obviously it's mostly the same as you would expect in an impromptu. That's definitely different, this what he's doing here with this, making it more staccato, which is you know, a different effect, I suppose. But I'm just impressed by the clarity of his playing, the fact that he's able to do this. You know, it's almost like semi-staccato all the way through. You know, you've got this like a sort of tenuto all the way through, which I think is really cool. Yeah, I've never really heard this played like this before. You know, it's definitely been mostly always legato from what I can remember. But thank you. striking the keys there, obviously to give a more percussive effect. He's not making it overly harsh though, he's just coming up whatever the chord that he's playing there is, but it's creating this kind of drama in the, you know, in the left hand part, which is kind of cool. I really like those staccato bits on these, you know, that section there. You know, I think that's brought out really well. I didn't even think to do it like that. I like the fact that he's bringing out the top part there, you know. So when he has these, and he's going there, you know, the fact that he's able to just to express it like that is just different. You know, it's definitely highly expressive playing. I didn't realize, I've probably forgotten as well. I mean, I've not played Schubert in a while, a long time, probably years. You know, he's not a composer that has particularly kind of resonated with me in that same sense. So I'm kind of glad that I listened to that to get a fresh perspective and to hear it kind of almost for the first time in a sense. And I didn't really remember the amount of detail that Schubert has in his music. You know, there's littered notes of just accents and crescendo, diminuendo, so many different articulations and colours that he brings out in the composition. But yeah, wow, I mean, Sokolov is a fantastic pianist. Yeah, definitely one I'm going to listen to in the future. Have we got any applause? No, it's probably doing it as part of a set of impromptus, I imagine. So tell me what you think down below in the comments. So should we do this type of formatting again? And did you enjoy Sokolov's playing as well? I mean, are you familiar with the Schubert impromptus? Let me know down below. And as always, I'll see you on the next one.